Good morning from what feels like a summer's day here in Snowdonia. I mean, it doesn't, but compared to what I've had on the last few days, this is beautiful. Now, I'm referring to this location as the Idwell Path. It's not called that, I'm sure it's not called that, but you've got Lynn Idwell, and then you've got the visitor centre, and linking the two is this path. So to my logic, it's the Idwell Path, but I'm sure I'll be corrected if I've got that wrong. I'm not even remotely close. Anyway, I was here a couple of days ago, and I shot this video here, and that video was pretty much shot from the Lynn up to the high vantage point where you see that iconic shot over Lynn Ogwin and Lynn Idwell. Why do I struggle with that word? Idwell. But the walk from the car park to Idwell is only 15 minutes, and it's really not a steep walk at all. It takes 15 minutes to get from the car park to the Lynn. And I just thought, you know, for anyone that can't get up really high and it's in this area, I think that this would be a great location to come. So what I'm going to do today, I'm literally just going to shoot from the Lynn back to the car park and just see if I can find anything. Now, I'm not going to be after that one particular image where I'm going to wait for an hour or two, you know, for that light to improve and all that. So, you know, these images may not be incredible, but hopefully they'll give you an idea of what is actually around here. Now, let me talk you through why I've chosen this particular location and kind of what goes through my mind here. Now, I quite like the slabs that are going across the path, but obviously what caught my eye is these slabs here, and obviously they're going with the path, so I just thought that was acting as a nice leading line into the frame. The only thing is where I'm standing at the moment with the vlogging camera, I don't know, to my eye, and this is only to my eye, it was taking me out of the frame and then coming back in. Now, I did move around a little bit with the tripod, and I just felt that just looked a little bit better, looking straight down the path, but with these slabs here coming in. Now, you know, it's always a danger when you say stuff like this on a video, because you get them back to the computer, and it might not quite be how you envisaged. But at the moment, I'm happy with this composition, and I'm quite happy with the way that I'm now looking down the valley. Plus, I'm getting a little bit of light in them clouds. So all I've done now, I've moved up no more than about 30 metres, and it's pretty much the same composition, but it is slightly different. And I'm going to try to explain it, but the best thing to do is if I just jump behind the camera, because it'll make life so much easier. So for this composition, there's something about these flagstones that are doing it for me, and I just don't know if it's my eye or my imagination, I should say. But anyway, let me talk you through it. Right, so this is roughly the composition that I'm going to go for. And I've actually moved to the right of the path with this composition, because I quite like these flagstones here almost look as if they're pointing towards that mountain. Okay, they're not lined up with the path, but I just feel that they are adding something. Now, I could be wrong, but I just feel that they are aiming at the mountain, and then the pathway comes around and then leads you down to the Lynn. I quite like these rocks here on the left-hand side as well. The only thing, by being here, there isn't a great deal of separation between the pathway and Lynn Ogwin. But I'm sure as I move higher, I'll be able to get that separation. Through the edges of my soul, and getting harder. It was never under my control. So before I actually get to the composition that I think may work, this is the bridge that I've got across to get there, but this is also the bridge where I drop my filters. There's a large rock there. I had my camera on the rock. I was on the bridge. I was holding it, so I wasn't being irresponsible. And then a huge gust of wind literally pinned me up against the railings. But my camera bag was down here. You can't see it, but my camera bag was down here. And I was just terrified things were gonna get blown out of it. It was that strong. So as I tried to get the camera and get back here, that's when I knocked the foundation holder. And it was like, what's that program on telly? Tipping Point. It literally hit the rock, hit the railing, hit the bridge, and I thought, oh, it's gonna be safe. And then it bounced again and found its way down the smallest of cracks into the stream. And I couldn't move. And then when the wind dropped, I looked, but it's pointless. I mean, that water's flowing so fast and it was all foamy white. I mean, how can you jump in and get that? You don't know where it's gonna end up. Anyway, I've got my new filters coming today. They're being delivered to my friends in Derbyshire. So by the time I get to Derbyshire tomorrow, I should have my filters back. Well, I have moved around quite a lot here. I've probably been here now for about half an hour, I suppose. And as I suspected when I was on the other side, you know, that tree, as pretty as that tree looks, it does get lost into the falls because it's so dark. And it's a shame because I think, I certainly can't get a shot of the falls because of that tree. But I'm going for a slightly different shot, and that is looking across the stream. Now, excuse me, there's a small tree on the bottom left-hand side of this frame, but I also want to get the waterfall in on the right-hand side, just before the tree. And I've got a 21mm lens on, and that's as wide as I can go. But I think I'm still clipping some of the branches on this small tree on the left-hand side. And I quite like that waterfall that's right in the background on the peaks. And the clouds is pretty good, actually. It's fairly uniform. So there's not like pockets of bright blue or high cloud poking through. It's very flat, but hopefully I won't have too much of that in the image. So I've had to mess around with my settings because I'm looking for a third or a half a second exposure. And so at the moment I'm on F16 ISO 100, and that's how I'm achieving that third or half a second exposure. Let me stay there for a while. I can see my filters. I can't believe it. It's nowhere near as windy today. So there's not as much kind of foam on the water, or unless I just couldn't see them the other day, but I can actually see them. Oh, this is gonna be so cold. I've taken off my thermals and my jeans. I've put my waterproofs back over the top. Not that they're waterproof, but it's not a pretty sight, me wading in there in my old skidders. I can't believe I got these back. I'll have to check them out. I don't know if they're scratched, but oh, you don't know how pleased I am. Well, my feet are not actually that sore, but it could be they're so numb I can't feel anything. Anyway, I am going to quickly take this shot now because it's on the way back to the van. And as you can see, I've got the tripod as high as I possibly can, because this big flat rock here, it looks really nice from a higher viewpoint. When you come low, you just kind of don't get the feel of how big it is or how flat it is. So I've gone as high as possible. I'm still bracketing because I need to dry my filters off. One exposure obviously for the landscape, one exposure for the sky, and I've just focused to infinity. Right, well, I've just put fresh socks on, had a quick cup of tea, and I'm all good to go again. Now, as you can see, I'm up by the falls, or I'm down by the falls, I should say. This is actually about a minute's walk from the car park, and it's the first thing you come to on this path. Now, I probably will take a few images lower down, but I wanted to start higher up at the moment. Now, I think that this would be a great shot kind of spring or summer, when all of this heather is in full bloom. I'm thinking, you know, possibly portrait with the camera angled down, so you get all of this heather here in the foreground. The only problem is, by doing that, the falls look minuscule, and I think it's the wrong time of year to do it, because the heather is so weak, the falls is so small, there's no real prominent feature. It's kind of, this is only my personal opinion, but it's quite a weak image all the way through, where I think that if the heather was in full bloom, like it's almost like bang, straight away, there's your foreground interest, really bright, really colourful, and then the rest of the landscape kind of is what it is. But yeah, without this colour here, yeah, for me, just a very weak image. Again, I think a composition that would work well, but on a different day. I really like this rock here on the left-hand side. And again, it's covered in heather. So that would be so colourful, you know, come next summer. There's also this fence here that leads you down to the falls. You know, again, the falls are going to look very small from here, but I just think the mountain is such a prominent feature, and this rock and heather would be a really prominent foreground and very colourful as well, that I think you could almost bypass the falls. The falls would be almost, for me, an added extra, an added bonus, rather than being the focal point actually of this image. And again, light always helps. Just on the other side of this fence here, I mean, again, you know, there's so much interest in there at the right time of year. There's loads of heather in there, loads of grasses, loads of rocks. And I think, you know, in that little area there, there's bound to be a shot. And directly behind you guys, where the camera is, you know, there's huge rocks there. So you'll be able to get something from perhaps a higher vantage point. But for me, this is definitely going to be the last composition of the day. There is no light, and it's just not worth me staying on. This is not going to improve anytime soon, but I'm just going to use this large rock here in the foreground with obviously the falls, and then just a little bit of sky showing. It's very, there's hardly any contrast, so I don't want to get too much of the sky in. So yeah, and then I might just zoom in tight and just get a closer shot of the falls. I'm not too sure, but this is me done. Anyway, thank you ever so much for watching. So I'm going to go now and clean my filters up and get ready for the next video. Thank you ever so much for watching, and until next week's video, see ya.